Hi friends out in YouTube land, it's Asenva here, and today I want to show you some really cool Daiso and Dollar Tree finds. So if you don't know what a Daiso is, it's basically like the Japanese Dollar Tree. And I can't really say it's too much like the Dollar Tree because not everything's a dollar. I think like the cheapest is like $1.50 because of course, you know, it's an import item, so they can't like just do, you know, the 100 like, you know, yen price that, you know, it would technically be or whatever. But they have a lot of really cool stuff inside of the Daiso. And then I actually traveled to my local Dollar Tree and I found a lot of really cool stuff that were perfect for my dolls. Let's start off with things from the Dollar Tree first. There was like a set of these little plastic pink chairs and they fit like my smaller dolls like perfectly. They're really cute. They're just little like simple plastic chairs and they came in a set of two. This girl's missing a shoe. And like it's perfect for a YoSD to sit in. So there's that. And I really like them. I think, I don't remember if I saw another color, but I just, you know, they came like this, like stacked, and you could buy a set of two. So it would be really easy to buy like a family table and you could have four there. But I like them just for my shelf right now. I kind of just have some dolls sitting on them. And I think, you know, they're cool. The good thing too is that they're plastic. So if you actually really wanted to spray paint this a different color, you really could. You could also probably spruce it up, you know, make a little cushion chair seating thing on the butt area here, you know, and just, you know, just really bedazzle them. But I just thought they were really neat and I couldn't pass it up for just a dollar. Another neat plastic seating item that was there was this purple couch. I think this is really neat and it could serve as a really good base if you're looking to, I guess like upholster something. I haven't tried it, but I feel like it would be really easy to use this as like a frame and then you could essentially like make your own little cushions and like, you know, put material over it or whatever. You could even spray paint it a different color if that's what you want to do. But yeah, it's a really cute little like love seat. And again, the little YoSD, she doesn't want to sit, there we go. Little YoSDs can sit in it and it makes like a cute little chair if you're making little dioramas or whatever. So again, a dollar. So now they did actually have a plastic bed too, but I kind of wasn't a big fan of the plastic bed. But thinking back on it now, I probably should have just purchased it anyway, because one, it's a dollar, and two, I could have probably customized it. I think it'd be really neat to customize these and try to put different things on them. Because, you know, it's just a dollar. Like, if you mess up, I mean, who cares? It was just a dollar for this, so. Really quickly, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and throw me a like. I would really appreciate it. I feel like there's a theme going on here. Everything that I have is like seating things, things for dolls to sit on. I'll be honest with you, this next one, I can't remember if I got it from the Daiso or the Dollar Tree, but it was just too funny. A toilet! What? Yeah, there was an actual toilet. And I don't know why, like why I would have this, other than like if you are making like a diorama, I guess this would be cute inside of the diorama if you're doing like a bathroom scene or something and, you know, you just need it there. It's a dollar. Again, it's more for like the YoSD range, you know, your 1/6 scale dolls. If I try to put like, you know, this A-zone on it, it's a pretty good size. It's just funny, like, I don't know, it was there and I just couldn't say no to it. It was just too funny, like, to pass up. Cause I mean, when do you see a toilet? Like, a play toilet, like, by itself. I kinda wish there was a tub too, but there was only a toilet there, so. I have a toilet. Another really cool item coming from the Dollar Tree was this clear bag. So, I have plans for this clear bag. It has a little zipper on top and it has these little pockets in the front, and I'm really into like Ida bags. I have one Ida bag that's like a magical girl bag, but I thought it'd be really cute like to make a BJD Ida bag out of this and stick like one of my dolls inside of it, my smaller ones. So like this is my A zone and she can kind of lay down in it like this. And I thought it'd be really cool to kind of make like a little thing for a doll to kind of just chill in here. And I could put like twinkle lights or something like that in it, or you know, little buttons or whatnot, her accessories there. I don't know, I just thought it was kind of cool. I haven't like fully committed to anything yet, but that was like the first thing that popped in my mind when I saw this little bag, because I was just like, oh man, this would be like a really cool like little Ida bag. I could just, you know, shove a doll in there and like maybe put twinkle lights or something, you know, I don't know. And I think another cool part to it is that since it's a dollar, like I really don't care about adjusting things and like rearranging it. Like I know it's got the handle here, but I could easily just pop the handle, the seams on the handle, and then make it a standing bag like this. And that way I can carry her around like in this little clear capsule type thing. You know, just make it my own. I think it'd be really cool to customize a little, you know, a little doll Ida bag and just carry my little BJD in it. And the last item that I have to show you all today from the Dollar Tree, this sweet motorbike. I think this motorbike is so cool looking and I think it's really good for the 1/6 scale dolls. I think what I'm gonna end up doing with this is I'm gonna like customize it. So I'm not a big fan of the stickers that are on it, but I would love to repaint this bike and make it like a different color and like, you know, draw some designs on it and stuff like that. And, you know, just make it just completely different and cool. It does look like it's a good size, like I said, for the 1/6 scale. I'm not sure. I haven't taken it out of the packaging to see if a USD would look good on it. I feel like they should. It looks pretty appropriate for them. But anything else, it kind of looks like a toy in front of like SDs and stuff like that. But a dollar, you know, a dollar to have some fun, you know, and customize something. I think it's really neat. And I'm excited to make a really cool looking, dirt bike. Okay, so let's shift gears and talk about the Daiso. So the Daiso has like a whole mess of just random things. And I think one of the things I like about the Daiso is that they have a lot of miniature items. If you were ever wondering like, let me see, I have a whole bunch of them here. If you're ever wondering, like I know I've shown in some of my other videos, like my little miniature erasers and things like that, the Daiso has like a whole bunch of them. I'm not sure if any of these came from the Daiso. I just know I've been collecting them over the years and people have gifted me fake food erasers. But I know they have a whole bunch of them at the Daiso there if you're looking for that sort of thing. But they do have, that's actually where I purchased, I don't know if I can sneak it out. A while back, I had also purchased these chairs. I think they were like made for phones. I'm not even sure if they're really made for dolls. I purchased like a clear one and then this white one. I think, I'm pretty confident that's where I got these from. Because I remember trying to take it back with me. If you don't know already, live in Texas and there is actually a Daiso that just opened up, I think like in Austin. And of course there's a Daiso in Dallas. And we had gone into both Daisos actually. So a lot of this stuff is collectively purchased from both places. But the first one I wanna share with you is this folding table. What? Yeah, it's really neat. It collapses. You can actually like fold it down like to travel with it and take it with you. It's supposed to be for like a plant, like a planter table type thing. But I looked at it and I was like, this is too cute. Like this would be perfect. I think, you know, I think it might be just a tad bit big. You know, this is a 1/6 scale doll next to it. So, you know, for our USD friends, it's a little bit big, but for like our 1/4 scale friends, like our MSD friend that we have right here. So it makes for like a cute little outdoor table. Like, you know, when you go outside and you have your outdoor furniture, that's kind of what it reminds me of. So I just couldn't say no to it. It's so cute. And definitely, you know, if I had some MSD seating, you know, she would sit quite well next to it. So I think it's really cool. And again, it was only $1.50. So, I mean, that's a steal. I would have loved to have purchased more. And then, like, again, since it's made out of, like, this kind of plywoody kind of material or wood, you can just repaint it a different color if you don't like the brown. And, you know, make it a completely different table. So one of the main things I always go to when I go to the Daiso is the doll section. So they actually do sell, like, their own, like, little line of, like, fashion dolls and stuff like that. And I will no joke just take everything off the shelf because they have probably the best 1/6 scale, like for Obitsus and A-Zones clothing that's only $1.50. So I kept one in its package so you can see what it looks like, and the other ones I just already had so much fun trying them on my dolls. They come packaged super nicely like this. They all usually come with a pair of shoes as well that match the outfit. So this one is kind of like a little kimono, like little yukata looking type outfit. I feel like whenever I go to like the Dollar Tree and I look at the doll section, doll clothing that's there, it's kind of like meh, you know, it usually doesn't look the best. Sometimes it's got like threads hanging out of it and stuff like that, or you know, the Velcro is really wonkily sewn on there. This is like prime. Like it's sewn like so perfectly, like so good and everything. Like I have not encountered a Daiso like doll clothing that I didn't like. I literally purchase, like, anytime I go there, that's the first thing I go to purchase. So I got this one, and then my other girls are wearing the other items. So this is one of my Obitsus, and I bought this little wedding dress set. So cute. Like, there's little beading here. It came with a little necklace, a little veil here. And it fit her really nicely. Again, like, I'm just so impressed because it's sewn so nicely. Like, really honestly, like, it's $1.50, you know? And I mean, to have, like, it be this good, you know, for something so small, like, I love it. It's like 10 out of 10. Like, I just want to buy all the outfits whenever I go to the Daiso. The other outfit I bought was kind of like a costume, and it was this one. I don't know like what you would consider it. It's kind of like a Little Red Riding Hood or like Alpine or I don't know, Dutch. I have no idea. But it's super cute. It kind of fits her a little bit short, and to be honest, this is like a larger bust than most dolls. So it was a little bit tight and snug to go ahead and put on with the Velcro in the back, but I made it work. And the best part is the shoes actually fit. So she's wearing the shoes that came with the outfit, and believe it or not, this girl's also wearing the shoes that came with her outfit too. This one also was a Daiso outfit. It's a little kimono thing that came with like a little bow too. And she's also wearing the shoes that they came with. I don't know if it came with this one actually. But these I know are Daiso shoes also. There's just so many different clothing sets and stuff like that that the Daiso sells for dolls that are this size range that it's just too good to pass up. So if you ever get a chance to go to the Daiso, definitely go check out the doll section. And if you have smaller scale dolls like this, like it fits them perfectly. Now, if you were to try to put them on a YoSD sized doll, I don't think, unfortunately, it will fit at all, just because the YoSD dolls typically tend to be a little bit thicker around like their waist and their chest. These are more very much like Barbie clothing. And even at that, it's kind of like a petite Barbie, really. So I don't think a lot of them will fit. I know I have had the chance of putting on like other like Ken clothing and stuff like that to YoSDs, but I really honestly don't think these would fit my YoSDs. I forgot this one's actually also an outfit that I got from the Daiso. And those were my finds. I would love to hear if you have gone to Dollar Trees or Daisos on your own and have found some really cool deals. Love to hear about it in the comment section down below. As always, I hope you guys have a fantastic and a dolly-tastic day. Don't forget that every Tuesday is Dolly Talk Tuesday here on my YouTube channel at 8 p.m. Central Time. That is our little live stream that we do here on YouTube, and we kind of just, you know, discuss whatever, and, you know, we'll have theme days and stuff, so stop on by. Stay safe, and I'll see you in another video soon. Bye! For our 1/4 scale friends, like our MSD friend that we have right here, it makes like a perfect kind of like little like a outdoor table or like a little picnic table. Struggling. So. Oh no. There we go. It's a lock it in place. For our 1/6 scale friends, like a USB.